चलिए बच्चों, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू एंड मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग वी हैव डिस्कस्ड। नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज कंपैरिजन बिटवीन फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग एंड मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग। बच्चों, फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग इज अ अकाउंटिंग सिस्टम दैट focuses on the preparation of financial statements of an organization to provide the financial information to the interested parties. Bachcho, financial accounting is an accounting system that has to be made compulsorily and it focuses on preparation of financial statements, that is P&L, profit and loss account, balance sheet. Through profit and loss account, you will get to know whether your company has earned profit or loss. Through balance sheet, you will get to know about the assets, liabilities, and financial position of the company. These reports, P&L, balance sheet, these are presented by the company to the stakeholders at the end of every year, and it is compulsory. Stakeholders are the person who have some stake, who have some interest in the company, whether they have invested in the company or someone who is interested, who is planning to invest in some company, will also like to see your profit and loss account and the financial position of the company. That's why I'm saying financial accounting is an accounting system that focuses on the preparation of financial statement of an organization to provide the financial information to the interested parties. Management accounting, the accounting system which provides relevant information to the managers to make policies, plans, and strategies for running the business effectively is known as management accounting. So management accounting is done just for the purpose of managers, so that managers get relevant information on regular basis. It helps managers to make policies, plans, and strategies for running the business effectively. It is not compulsory to make management accounting because this is just presented before the managers so that they can make policy, plans, and strategy for running the business effectively and efficiently. Okay, so is it compulsory to make financial accounting? Yes. Because at the end of every year, the company need to present the financial accounts before the stakeholders. Is it compulsory to prepare management accounting? No. But in financial accounting, only monetary information is there. Profit and loss, balance sheet, or whatever general entry for ledger you make. In all that, only monetary information is there. But in management accounting, monetary and non-monetary information both are given. Objective of financial accounting: to provide financial information to outsiders. To provide financial information to outsiders. Objective of management accounting: to assist the management in planning and decision-making process by providing detailed information on various matters. So objective of financial accounting is to provide financial information to the outsiders, and objective of management accounting is to assist the management in planning and decision making process by providing detailed information on various matters. Thank you. I told you financial statements are prepared at the end of accounting period and it is usually for 1 year. Whereas management accounting reports are prepared as per the need and requirement of the organization. So management accounting reports are made, are prepared as per the needs and requirements of the organization. Who are the users of financial statement? Financial statements have internal as well as external parties. Whereas for management reports, only internal management is the user, because only management fees management reports, which help them in making policies, strategies to run the business efficiently and effectively. Reports. Summarized reports about financial position of the organization. In financial accounting, you will get the summarized report about the financial position of the organization. And in management accounting, you will get the complete and detailed report regarding various information. Publishing and audit. Bachcho, financial accounts are required to be published and audited by a statutory auditor. Bachcho, management accounting is just for the purpose of management. They are neither published nor audited by the statutory auditors. Then, difference between management and cost accounting. The main objective of cost accounting is to assist the management in cost control and decision making. The main objective of cost accounting is it assists the management to control the cost and in decision making. The primary objective of management accounting is to provide necessary information to management in the process of its planning, controlling, performance evaluation and decision making. Cost accounting system uses quantitative cost data that can be measured in monetary terms. But so in cost accounting, we only use quantitative data that can be measured in monetary terms. But in management accounting, we use both quantitative and qualitative data. It can be used those data that cannot be measured in terms of money. So in cost accounting, there is only monetary data, and in management accounting, there can be monetary as well as non-monetary data. Determination of cost and cost control are the primary roles of cost accounting. So primary role of cost accounting is to determine cost so that we can control the cost if in any department cost is very much high. And effective performance of the concern is the primary role of management accounting. So management accounting's primary role is to see, is to check that business is running effectively. Success of cost accounting does not depend upon management accounting, but success of management accounting depends on sound cost accounting as well as financial accounting system, because management accounting will get the data from cost accounting as well as financial accounting. Cost related data as obtained from financial accounting is the base of cost accounting. Management accounting is based on the data as received from financial accounting and cost accounting. I told you, cost related data obtained from financial accounting is the base of cost accounting, and management accounting receives the data from financial accounting and cost accounting. Okay. Cost accounting provide future cost related decisions based on the historical cost information, whereas management accounting provide historical and predictive information for future decision making. So, bachcho, cost related data that provide future cost accounting provide future cost related decision, whereas management accounting help in making a decision for the future of the company. Cost accounting reports are useful to the management as well as shareholders and creditors of a concern. Management accounting prepares report exclusively meant for the management only. Cost accounting principles are used in it, in cost accounting data. Principle of cost accounting as well as financial accounting both are used in management accounting. Statutory audit of cost accounting reports are necessary in some cases, especially big business houses. No statutory requirement of audit for reports. So, bachcho, the business which are very huge, which are very big, they are required to make their cost accounting audit. Whereas, they There is no statutory requirement of audit for There is no statutory requirement of audit for management accounting. Cost accounting is restricted to cost-related data. Management accounting uses financial data as well as cost accounting data both. Okay. Generally accepted accounting principles. Generally accepted accounting principles is known as GAAP. They are commonly known as GAAP. GAAP are the rules for the preparation of financial statement. Every public traded company must release their financial statement at the end of each year. So, बच्चों GAAP are generally accepted accounting principle. In this, there are some rules are given. The rules that you have to follow while preparing the financial statement. Such rules which every company have to follow for preparing the financial statements are given in GAAP, generally accepted accounting principles. These statements are used by investors, banks, and creditors to determine the financial health of the company and its suitability for investment or extension of credit. Now, बच्चों, suppose I want to invest 1 crore rupees in some company. If all the companies are making financial statement by different methods, then how can I be able to compare the financial position of the company? How can I compare the company? Whatever the investor is, investor will always compare the company. And where the investor found the maximum profit in that company, only the investor will invest the money. Now, I am an investor of a company. I am an investor. I want to invest 1 crore rupees. Now, if all the companies are making financial accounting by different methods, how can I compare the financial position of all the companies? That's why GAAP is here, generally accepted accounting principle. Every company have to follow these rules and regulations which are given in GAAP so that there can be uniformity in their accounting making process. So there can be uniformity in their accounting reports. Now, as an investor, if I want to invest in some company, what I want to see is what is the financial health of the company? What is the financial position of the company? Only then I will going to invest in that company. Now, all the companies are making financial position by the same method, following the same method. Now I can compare, I will compare the balance sheet and P&L of all the companies, and whichever company I like, I will invest in that company. In order to properly compare and evaluate companies and their result, financial position must provide similar information in a similar format. In order to properly compare and evaluate companies and their results, financial statement provide similar information in similar format so that it can be easy to compare and evaluate different companies. Every country has its own generally accepted accounting principles, and all publicly released financial statements must comply with these rules. But so every company have their own generally accepted accounting principles, and whatever financial statement they make, they have to comply with these rules and regulations which are given in the GAAP, which they have to follow. So what are the four key assumptions? अच्छा चलो बच्चों, why gap is important? Let us discuss that also. But why is gap important, sir? Why is gap so important? Now बच्चों suppose there are these two companies. A Limited is having a profit of 10 lakh for 5 years. B Limited is having a profit of 3 lakh for 5 years. I am an investor. In which company I will invest? Sir, obviously, we will invest in A Limited because A Limited has earned a profit of 10 lakh in 5 years, and B Limited has earned a profit of only 3 lakh in 5 years. But as per GAAP, you have to disclose the profit of each year individually. As per generally accepted accounting principle, every company have to disclose the profit of each year individually. Now, as an investor, I see that A Limited earned a profit of 2 lakh in 2010. A Limited earned a profit of 5 lakh in 2011. A Limited earned a profit of 6 lakh in 2012. In 2013, A Limited is having a loss of 1 lakh. In 2014, A Limited is having a loss of 2 lakh. So total profit is 10 lakh. Now, I will see that A Limited is having losses in the last 2 years. A Limited is having losses in the last 2 years. Whereas B Limited profit is 50,000, then 1 lakh, then 50,000, 50,000, 50,000. I have seen that B Limited is continuously earning profit in last 5 years, whereas A Limited is having losses in last 2 years. Now, this will change my decision because I will never invest in a company which is having losses in the last 2 years. In fact, I will invest in B Limited because B Limited is continuously earning profit. So, बच्चों, that's why gap is there, so that you have to follow these rules and regulations while preparing financial statements, so that the investors cannot be cheated. You cannot cheat the investors. That's why gap is so important. Now, four key assumptions is the general accounting principles. Four key assumptions is the generally accepted accounting principles. But the four key assumptions of GAAP are business entity, going concern, monetary unit, and time period principle. The business entity assumption is the idea that the business function as a legal and financial entity separate from its owner or any other business. This assumption means that all the amounts shown in revenue or expense in the financial statements are for the business alone and do not include any personal expense. But so whenever you start a business, it is assumed that the owner of business and the company both will be treated as different personality. Because in business, many people have invested their money. So there are a lot of owners. As per accounting, we treat company and the owner of company both as a different personality. If company has taken anything from the owner, company has to return. If company has given anything from to the owner, company will take it back. So separate from its owner, company is treated as separate from its owner. Owner cannot include any personal expense in the company expenses. Company expenses are different and owner's expenses are different. For example, Rahul and Aditya, you both are different person. Whatever Rahul do, Aditya do not get affected. Whatever Aditya do, Rahul do not get affected. Same way, company and its owner are treated as different personalities. Whatever company do, owner does not get affected. Whatever owner do, company does not have any effect. Going concern. Going concern is the assumption that the company will operate for the foreseeable future. But so going concern assumption says that company will keep on operating no matter whether the owner is there or not. Company will operate for infinite period. This is an assumption that whenever you start a company, that company will keep on running for indefinite period. This is important. One stable currency. We are talking about monetary unit. This is important when calculating the value of assets, depreciation and amortization. Monetary unit assumption is that all amounts listed use one stable currency and that any amount in another currency are clearly listed. Time period assumes that all the transactions reported did in fact occur within the time period as listed. But so one stable currency means if you are doing accounting in India, you have to do accounting in rupees. It is not like you are doing accounting in rupees, dollar, euros, no. If you are doing accounting in India, there is one stable currency, that is rupees. You have to do accounting in rupees so that the investor, it will be simple, easy for the investor to compare the financial position of the different companies. Time period assumption that all the transactions reported did in fact within the time period is listed. But so time period says that whatever transaction happened within 1 year, you have to report it. For example, the employees working in your company, the salary get due for 12 months and you have paid a salary of 10 months. Then also you have to show salary of 12 months because expenses is incurred for 12 months. Salary expenses has incurred for 12 months, but you have paid for 10 months, that does not matter. Now, let us do some MCQs. Bachcho, MCQs will help you in getting clarity on the topic. Your whole topic will automatically get revised if you try to attempt the MCQs. That's why it is very important and most important to attempt the MCQs. Let us see. The process of preparing management reports and accounts that provide accurate and timely financial and statistical information required by manager to make day-to-day and short-term decisions. A. Cost accounting. B. Management accounting. C. Financial accounting. D. None of the above. Answer is B. Management accounting. Objects of management accounting: to assist in planning, B, to assist in organizing, C, to assist in motivating, D, all of the above. Objective of management accounting, answer is D, all of the above, to assist in planning, organizing and motivating. Accounting system that focuses on the preparation of financial statement of an organization to provide the financial information to the interested parties. A. Cost accounting. B. Management accounting. C. Financial accounting. D. None of the above. Accounting system that focuses on the preparation of financial statement. Answer is C. Financial accounting. Provide financial information to outsider. A. Cost accounting. B. Management accounting. C. Financial accounting. D. None of the above. Answer is C. Financial accounting provide financial information to outside. The reports are prepared as per the need and requirement of the organization. Cost accounting, management accounting, financial accounting, none of the above. Reports prepared as per the need and requirement of organization. Answer is B. Management accounting. Required to be published and audited by a statutory auditor. A. Cost accounting. B. Management accounting. C. Financial accounting. D. None of the above. What is required to be published and audited by a statutory auditor? Answer is C. Financial accounting. Uses quantitative cost data that can be measured in monetary terms. Cost accounting, B. Management accounting, C. Financial accounting, D. None of the above. Uses quantitative cost data that can be measured in monetary terms. Quantitative. Answer is B or फी फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग विद डेट कैन मेजर्ड इन मॉनेटरी टर्म. व्हाट इज मेजर्ड इन मॉनेटरी टर्म? बच्चों आंसर इज ए कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग. इट यूजेस क्वांटिटेटिव डेटा डेट कैन बी मेजर्ड इन मॉनेटरी टर्म. प्रोवाइड फ्यूचर रिलेटेड डिसीजन बेस्ड ऑन हिस्टोरिकल कॉस्ट इंफॉर्मेशन. फ्यूचर कॉस्ट रिलेटेड डिसीजन कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग, मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग, फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग, ऑल ऑफ द अबव. फ्यूचर कॉस्ट रिलेटेड डिसीजन इज ऑब्टेन्ड बाय कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग. Now I'm sharing another PPT with you. Now, Bachchu, we are going to start with ratio analysis. In this, we will discuss meaning of ratio, objective of ratio analysis, advantages and uses of accounting ratio, limitations of accounting ratios, classifications of ratio on the basis of liquidity ratio, solvency ratio, activity ratio, turnover ratio, profitability or income ratio. Practical part will start now. What is ratio? I told you, relationship between two figures can be that can be expressed in arithmetical term is called as ratio. Relationship between two figures that can be expressed in arithmetical term is known as ratio. For example, बच्चों, इन अ क्लास देर आर 20 बॉयज एंड 10 गर्ल्स. इन अ क्लास देर आर 20 बॉयज एंड 10 गर्ल्स. व्हाट इज द बॉयज ऑफ हिज गर्ल्स रेशियो? सो 20 रेशियो 10 और 2 रेशियो 1. सो वी कैन से दैट ऑन एवरी टू बॉयज देर इज वन गर्ल. इन अ क्लास देर आर 20 बॉयज एंड 10 गर्ल्स. सो रेशियो इज 2:1. ऑन एवरी टू बॉय देर इज वन गर्ल. On every two boy, there is one girl. What is the asset and liability ratio? But you know, some of the asset is 5 lakh and liability is 4 lakh. Ratio will be 5:4. Ratio will be 5:4. So, but you know, ratio means relationship between two figures expressed in arithmetical term is known as ratio. Relationship between two figures expressed in arithmetical term. Arithmetical matlab mathematical term 2:1, 5:4 is called as ratio. So now ratio can be expressed in different form. Ratio can be expressed in proportion. Current asset 1 lakh, current liability 50,000. So ratio is 2:1. 2:1 is known as proportion. Ratio can be expressed as rate also. For example, credit sale 4 lakh, trade receivable 40,000. It means trade receivable turnover is 10 times. So it can be expressed in terms of percentage also. A capital is 1 lakh, profit is 5 lakh. So 5 lakh upon 1 lakh into 100. So profit is 50%. That these, all this we are going to discuss in illustrations. We have already discussed also. Again, we will discuss. For the ratio analysis, is used to evaluate relationship among financial statement items. For example, we will always want to know what is the relationship between current asset and current liability, because current asset should be more and current liability should be less. What is the relationship between equity and debt? What is the relationship between profit and cost? What is the rate of profit? And all these things we get to know through ratio analysis. Ratio analysis is used to evaluate relationship among financial statements item. Ratios are used to identify trends over time from one organization or to compare two or more organization at one point of time. Bachcho, through ratio, you can compare one organization with the other organization very easily in a simple form. One day is you will see all the current asset and all the current liability of every company. Another way is you will just see the current liability ratio of one company and current liability ratio of another company, and then you can compare. So what will be simple? So ratio is simple. Ratio analysis is an important tool for any business organization. The computation of ratio facilitates the comparison of firms which differ in size. ratio can be used to compare a firm's financial performance with industry average. In addition, ratio can be used in form of trend analysis to identify area where performance has improved or deteriorated over time. For example, bachcho, our profit ratio of 2010 was, let's take an example. Let me write here. We have taken out net profit ratio. Net profit ratio of year 2010 is 50%. It means my company is earning 50% profit in 2010. Net profit ratio It means my company is earning 45% profit in 2011. But so now, through ratio analysis, we have calculated net profit ratio. In 2010, the net profit ratio was 50%. In 2011, the net profit ratio is 45%, and in 2012, net profit ratio is 40%. Now, through ratio analysis, I will see that my net profit ratio is decreasing day by day. Now, I will check what are the reasons behind it. I will find out the reason, I will increase the efficiency, and I will try to improve my net profit ratio. So, this is how ratio analysis is going to help. Ratios are symptoms like blood pressure, the pulse or temperature of an individual. Just as in the case of individual, a doctor or a valid by reading the pulse of a patient or by studying the blood pressure or temperature of the patient can diagnose the cause of his ailment. So also a financial analyst, through ratio analysis of the employment of resources and its overall financial position. Just as in medical science, the symptoms are passive factors. To diagnose them properly depends upon the efficiency and the expertise of the doctor. So also to derive right conclusions from ratio analysis will depend upon the efficiency and depth of understanding of the financial analyst. But so, if you are not feeling good, what you do? You went to a doctor. The doctor will check your pulse, and just by checking your pulse, he will tell you the symptoms and he will write the medicines. Because doctor is an expert in that field. By just checking the pulse of the patient, he can diagnose what is the reason that this patient is feeling not good. He will diagnose the disease. He will diagnose the cause of illness just by checking the pulse of a patient. Because doctor is an expert of that field. In the same way, ratios are like pulse of a business. The financial analyst, matlab the experts will just by checking the ratio can tell the financial position of the company. Same like doctors by checking the pulse can diagnose the reason for the patient illness. In the same way, by checking the ratio, the financial analyst can tell the overall financial position of the company. So these ratios are like pulse for any company. Accounting ratios are very useful tools for grasping the true message of the financial statement and understanding that. Ratio normally should be worked out between figures that are significantly related to one another. Obviously, no purpose will be served by working out ratios between two entirely unrelated figures, such as discount on debentures and sales. Ratios can be worked out on the basis of figures contained in the financial statement. बच्चों अकाउंटिंग रेशियोज आर वेरी यूजफुल टूल सो एज टू नो द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट ऑफ अ कंपनी एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग देम बट रेशियो शुड बी बिटवीन द फिगर्स दैट आर रिलेटेड टू वन अनदर दैट करंट एसेट करंट लायबिलिटी प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस डेब्ट एंड इक्विटी इफ यू आर कंपेयरिंग बिटवीन प्रॉफिट एंड करंट एसेट देयर इज नो कंपैरिजन इफ यू आर कंपेयरिंग long term loan with sale there is no comparison there is no use of ratio analysis then so bachcho the purpose of ratio analysis is to compare two figures that are related to one another obviously no purpose will be served by comparing our ratio between two entirely unrelated figures now Let us do some practical part also. Bachcho, current asset is given, cash 1000, debtor 2000. Current liability is given, creditor 500, overdraft 1000. You have to calculate current asset and current liability ratio. Non-current asset machine 5000, non-current liability debentures 3000. बच्चों करंट एसेट रेशियो फॉर्मूला इज करंट एसेट डिवाइड बाय करंट लायबिलिटी नाउ करंट एसेट्स आर 1000 एंड 2000 फॉर 1000 प्लस 2000 करंट लायबिलिटी इज 500 प्लस 1000 फॉर 500 प्लस 1000 3000 डिवाइड बाय 1500 सो करंट रेशियो इज 2:1 इन बच्चों नाउ यू सी इन करंट रेशियो वी हैव नॉट कंसीडर्ड दिस non-current asset and current liability in current ratio we have not considered non-current asset and non-current liability because we are comparing current asset and current liability so while comparing current asset and current liability I will only take current assets and current liability we have not taken non-current asset and non-current liability so that's why I am saying that in ratio analysis we compare two figures that are related to one another not the figures that are not related Now let us do some MCQs. At the end of every topic, we do some MCQs. Now let us do some MCQs also. The key assumption is generally accepted accounting principle are. The key assumptions in generally accepted accounting principles are A. Business entity. B. Going concern. C. Monetary term. D, all of the above. Answer is D, all of the above. Assumptions that the business will operate for the foreseeable future. A, business entity. B, going concern. C, monetary term. D, accounting period principle. Assumption that business will operate for the foreseeable future. Answer is going concern. B. Assumption is that all the amounts listed use one stable currency and that any amount in other currency are clearly listed. A. Business entity. B. Going concern. C. Monetary unit. D. Time period principle. Answer is C. Monetary unit. Next. Assumption that all the transactions reported did in fact occur within the time period as listed. A. Business entity. B. Going concern. C. Monetary unit. D. Time period principle. Answer is D. Time period principle. Relationship between two figures expressed in arithmetical term is called ए कॉस्टिंग, बी रेशियो, सी अकाउंटिंग, डी नन ऑफ द अबव। आंसर इज बी रेशियो। रेशियो इज अ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन टू फिगर एक्सप्रेस्ड इन अर्थमेटिकल टर्म। इन अ क्लास देर आर 50 बॉयज एंड 20 गर्ल्स, वॉट इज द बॉयज टू गर्ल्स रेशियो? ए 1:2, बी 2:5, सी 5:2, डी 2:1। 50 बॉयज एंड 20 गर्ल्स, रेशियो इज 5:2, सी। करंट एसेट 30,000, करंट लाइबिलिटी 10,000। करंट एसेट 30,000, करंट लाइबिलिटी 10,000। कैलकुलेट करंट रेशियो। ए 2:1, बी 1:2, सी 3:1, 5:2, डी 5:2। आंसर इज 3:1, सी। इट इज कैलकुलेटेड हाउ मेनी टाइम अ फिगर इज इन कंपैरिजन टू अनदर फिगर। हाउ मेनी टाइम्स? ए रेट, बी परसेंटेज, सी प्रपोर्शन, डी नन ऑफ द अबव। आंसर इज बी परसेंटेज। इट इज एक्सप्रेस बाय सिंपल डिवीजन ऑफ वन नंबर बाय अनदर। ए रेट, बी परसेंटेज, सी प्रपोर्शन, डी नन ऑफ द अबव। आंसर इज सी प्रपोर्शन। रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन टू फिगर्स इज एक्सप्रेस्ड इन 100। ए रेट, बी परसेंटेज, सी प्रपोर्शन, डी नन ऑफ द अबव। आंसर इज सी परसेंटेज, बी परसेंटेज, बी। नाउ आई एम शेयरिंग अनदर पीपीटी विद यू। ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ रेशियो एनालिसिस, टू लोकेट वीक स्पॉट ऑफ बिजनेस व्हिच नीडेड मोर अटेंशन। ऑब्वियसली बच्चों, थ्रू रेशियो एनालिसिस वी विल गेट टू नो that which are the weak points of business, so that we can put more focus, more attention on those points and try to improve that. To provide deeper analysis of the liquidity, solvency, activity and profitability of the business. To provide information useful for making estimate and preparing plan for the future. It also helps in making estimate and plan for the future. To provide information for making cross-sectional time series analysis. Advantages or uses of accounting ratio. Number one, helpful in analyzing of financial statements. Helps user to know about the financial position of business. Bachcho, ratio analysis help the accounting users to know about the financial position of business. Helpful in comparing study. It helps in comparison of profit of different firm so that you can take a decision that in which company you need to invest. Simplification of accounting data. Simplify the long data of accounting. Yes, obviously, simplify the long data of accounting. One way is that you will add all the assets and then you will add all the liability. Then you will get to know the asset and liability ratio. One is just take out the ratio of asset and liability and you need not to add. Helpful in locating weak spot of business. Yes, through accounting ratio, we will get to know the weak spot of business. So that we can work on those weak spots and increase the efficiency of the business. Helpful in forecasting, it helps in plan for future. Fixation of ideal standard for comparison, it fixes a standard for comparing the data. Estimate about the trend of business, it also estimates the trend of business that whether our sale is going up or our sale is going down. Limitations of accounting ratio. Limitation means disadvantages. What are the disadvantages of accounting ratio? False accounting data gives false ratio. But so if your accounting data are false, then obviously the ratios will also be false because ratios are made with accounting data. If accounting data are false, then ratios will obviously be false. Comparison not possible if different firm adopt different accounting policy. Yes. If bachcho different firm adopt different accounting policy, then it is not possible to make comparison. Window dressing. If you are showing high profit or low profit to save taxes, if you are showing high profit to attract loan, and if you are showing low profit to escape from high taxes, it is known as window dressing. Then your accounting ratio will be false. ignore qualitative factor. It ignore qualitative factor because it take into consideration only quantitative data. Lack of proper standard. Because of lack of proper standard, accounting ratio cannot be made. Limited use of single ratio. Ratio alone are not adequate for proper conclusions. Only ratio are not adequate for proper conclusions. Now, what is the classification of ratio? Ratio can be classified into liquidity ratio, solvency ratio, activity or turnover ratio, profitability or income ratio. Now, bachcho, in next class, we are going to start the practical part. We will discuss liquidity ratios, solvency ratios, activity and turnover ratios, profitability and income ratios. From the next class, our practical part is going to start. So thank you everyone for joining. Please take care, stay safe, stay healthy.